We're back now with the future of Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein in question. If he's fired, if he resigns, one of the key questions is who could replace him in overseeing the special counsel's Russia investigation. The next person, technically in the line of succession here at the Justice Department, is Noel Francisco. He's the Solicitor General. He was appointed in 2017 and was instrumental in relaunching President Trump's travel ban. He is a former partner at Jones Day, and he previously worked in the George W. Bush White House. So let's go straight to CNN contributor Garrett Graff. Who knows a lot about these folks running in these circles. And Garrett, you know, Washington, D.C. is a big city, but it's also a small town. So you tell me more about Francisco and who Francisco knows if he were to step into this role.
So Noel Francisco, the Solicitor General, which is the person who argues on behalf of the U.S. government in front of the Supreme Court, it's one of the sort of most important and most storied roles in Washington. It's, right down to the traditional long-tailed garb, the formal morning jackets that the Solicitors Generals wear at the Supreme Court. But this is someone who is well known in Washington, someone who is one of the government's and sort of the most renowned conservative legal appellate jurists in the city, and someone who worked for George W. Bush both in the White House and in the Office of Legal Counsel, which is one of those little known entities outside of Washington that is effectively the in-house law firm for the Justice Department from 2003 to 2005, where he worked right under then Deputy Attorney General James Comey.
Wow, there you go. So the Comey connection, but then there was also the Trump presidential campaign connection, because didn't he also work at the law firm that represented Trump's campaign? Would that be a conflict of interest?
So, and there is some reason to believe that he has been recusing himself from at least some of the activities where there could be a conflict of interest with his former firm. It's unclear whether that would carry forward if he ends up supervising the Mueller probe. But there's plenty of reasons to believe that he would not necessarily come into this role with a goal of kneecapping Bob Mueller right off the top. He has spoken in the past about the challenges of special counsels, of outside investigators, in his role of executive authority. But again, these are, as you said at the top, these are small circles of people who have known each other, worked with each other for years. He was at OLC for that famous Stellar Wind showdown, the hospital incident with Jim Comey and Bob Mueller and John Ashcroft against the Bush White House. So he's been in the midst of these circles, serving alongside, at the time, then Assistant Attorney General Christopher Wray, who headed the criminal division, now the FBI director himself.
Yeah, and so maybe you're saying maybe he wouldn't kneecap Mueller, to use your turn of phrase, if he were to take on this role. What about if Rosenstein does get fired or resigns, how would that impact morale at DOJ, people who know him in those circles?
It's really hard to say, because part of the challenge right now is it's not entirely clear that the Mueller probe can really be entirely shut down. There are parts of the Mueller probe sort of scattered across the government right now. Remember, some of the most active investigation taking place in the Southern District of New York, the top federal prosecutor in Manhattan. That's where Michael Cohen ended up pleading guilty to those 8 charges related to campaign finance violations, bank fraud, tax fraud. That investigation still ongoing. Mueller's investigation, different parts of it have been handed off to different other offices, including the Southern District and the National Security Division here at the Department of Justice in Washington. So Mueller's investigation is no longer just, Bob Mueller sitting by himself in an office. Not that it ever really was, but it's a complicated probe with a lot of moving parts right now.